Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my latest project! Oh man, I got computer glare in my face. Can't even see anything. Let's see. I also have really bad eyesight, so I'll squint. So, this fall semester, I'm going to be working on a roguelike action RPG when I'm not busy with work and school. My goal is to get at least 5 hours of coding done per week, but I'm hoping for more of like a 10-hour per week average. I think that's kind of a reasonable amount. Based on what the work I've done so far, it looks like I really work for 1 to 3 hour increments anyway, so getting a couple programming sessions in per week would be ideal, or at the bare minimum would be pretty good, and then getting more than that would be great. But we'll see how busy this semester is with, you know, working in class and stuff like that. So, Knight-o-naut, as the game is called, is an open source RPG. Everything's on GitHub already. It's written in C++ with SFML2. And it's a little bit inspired by Sword of Fargol, as well as Diablo and Link to the Past. So I really like kind of classic roguelike games, but at the same time I'm going to try to make the battle system feel a little bit more like Link to the Past or Zelda games. And then I'm wanting to have a leveling up system kind of like Diablo, but nothing's really set in stone right now. That's kind of one of the fun things about working for yourself, is you could be like, I don't want to implement this, I'll redesign. But we'll see what it evolves into. I have a few different ideas. I don't really have anything concrete, so I'll do something, I'll make something, we'll see what it does. So in this vlog, I'll be talking about art, programming, organization, design. And for this first video, I will talk about what I've done so far with the procedural level generation. So one good resource to check out if you're interested in procedural generation is the Procedural Content Generation Wiki. It has sections split up with things like mazes, maps, worlds, and dungeons, but it also has more than just level generation, like procedural stories, generating textures, and all sorts of cool things. I read a few articles on level generation, and this is how I ended up implementing it. First, I created a 2D array of integers, with everything initialized to 0, which means just empty space. I would randomly choose how many rooms to create, and then for each of those rooms, randomly choose an X and Y coordinate for the room's center point. After creating each room's center point, I iterated through every room. Each room was linked to the room immediately prior to it by replacing the immediate, empty tiles with floor tiles. Then, iterating through every room's center point again, I would randomly choose room width and height to get a rectangular room. I would then fill in the surrounding area with the floor tiles. Finally, I would add walls to the map. I would check every empty space immediately above a floor tile, and if adding a wall and a ceiling tile above it doesn't cut off any other floor tiles, I would add a wall and a ceiling. If adding a wall and a ceiling would cut off a floor, I would add a barrel instead. Here are some examples of maps generated within the game so far. Do you have a devlog on YouTube? Let me know, and I'll include a link to yours at the end of my devlogs. And as always, thank you for watching! Roguelike action RPG. Oh god, I still can't even read this shit. My eyesight sucks.